For the love of Christ controls us, since we have concluded this, that Christ died for all, therefore all have died. The second epistle to the Corinthians, chapter 5, verse 14. How much do you owe, my Lord? Has he ever done anything for you? Has he forgiven your sins? Has he covered you with the robe of righteousness? Has he set your feet upon a rock? Has he established your goings? Has he prepared heaven for you? Has he prepared you for heaven? Has he written your name in his book of life? Has he given you countless blessings? Has he laid up for you a store of mercies which eye has not seen nor ear heard? Then do something for Jesus worthy of this love. Do not merely give worthy offerings to a dying Redeemer. How will you feel when your Master comes if you must confess you did nothing for him, but kept your love shut up like a stagnant pool, neither flowing forth to his poor or to his work? Let us rid ourselves of such love as that. What then do we think of a love which never shows itself in action? Why, they would say, open rebuke is better than secret love. Who will accept a love so weak it does not actuate you into a single deed of self-denial, of generosity, of heroism or zeal? Think how he loved you, gave himself up for you. Do you know the power of that love? Then let it be like a mighty rushing wind to your soul, sweeping out the clouds of your worldliness, clear away the mists of sin. For Christ's sake, be this the tongue of fire that shall sit upon you. For Christ's sake, be this divine rapture, the heavenly afflatus to bear you aloft from earth, the divine spirit that shall make you bold as lions and swift as eagles in your Lord's service. Love should give wings to the feet of service and strength to the arms of labour. Fixed on God with a constancy that cannot be shaken, or resolute to honour him with a determination that is not to be turned aside, pressing on with an ardour never to be weaned, let us show the constraints of love to Jesus. May the divine lodestone draw us heavenward toward itself. Amen.